Good evening, everybody. My name is Amuta. I'm working in Indian Embassy. So I just found, I have a lot of questions, but for time being, I'm saying little bit questions. So in Islam, why there is no caste system?
Yes, sister.
Okay, my second question.
Sister, ask the first question. After I reply, you can ask second question.
Okay, fine. Give me the answer.
Sister, ask the question, why in Islam there's no caste system? Because in Islam, we believe that all the human beings are equal. Unlike in Hinduism. Quran says in Surah Hujurat, chapter 49, verse number 13, Ya ayyuha an-nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila litarafu inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum inna Allahi alimun khabir. O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you shall recognize each other, not you shall despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the person who has taqwa. The criteria for judgment in the sight of Almighty God, for a human being to be superior to the other human being, it's not sex, it's not caste, it's not color, it's not wealth, it's not age, but it is taqwa, it is God consciousness, it is piety, it is righteousness. The only way one human being can be superior to the other human being, it's not by wealth, it's not by age, it's not by sex, but it is by piety, it is by God consciousness, it's by righteousness. Unlike Hinduism, when we read the Vedas, it's mentioned that Almighty God, He created the Brahmin class, the learned class from the head. That's the first caste. Then He created the warrior class, the Kshatriyas, from the chest. Then from His stomach and thighs, He created the business community, the Vaishyas. And from the feet, He created the Shudras, that's the untouchables, that's the lower caste. So this is what is mentioned in the Vedas. In Islam, we believe that all the human beings are equal. We don't believe that one human being is superior to the other human being because of birth, because of profession, because of wealth, because of color, because of caste. So Islam is a universal religion. Unlike in the Vedas, what they say that you have to stick to your profession. Because, you know, it was mainly controlled by the Brahmins, which is again small percentage. Minor percentage, and they say that if you're born as a Shudra, you remain a Shudra, you serve the Brahmin, next life maybe you may become a better person. No, this is all ideology. So that, you know, they want to keep the person low, person will remain low, and the rich and the top people remain top. In Islam, we believe in equality. And Islam is a religion for all the human beings. That is the reason Islam is against caste system. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Okay, sir, I have one more doubt. So why you are saying the Muslim is Sayyid Muslim or Sunni Muslim or Shia? So what is that?
Sister said that why am I saying Sayyid Muslim and Shia Muslim Sunni? I never said Sayyid Muslim. Muslim is the one who submits his will to Almighty God. In Islam, there is no sect. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse 103, وَاتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. There is no Sayyid Muslim and Sunni or this. Yes, the family. Fine, you may belong to a family. You may belong to a Sheikh family. You may belong to Sayyid family. To know your roots, that does not mean a person is superior. A Khan is superior to a Sheikh or a Sayyid. No. It is belonging to your roots. Like how you may come from some family so that you have come from particular land or particular area. If you have come from Konkan region. So this is family background. It doesn't mean one person is superior to the other. The only way one human being can be superior to the other human being is by piety, is by righteousness, is by God consciousness. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Okay, second question. Why in Islam marriages no horoscope is seen?
Sister asked the question that why in Islam during marriages no horoscope is seen? Because, sister, we don't believe in horoscope.
There is no date of birth. Based on the date of birth, you are not seeing any horoscope?
Yes, sister, I'll come to it. I will tell you what Hinduism says, because I studied Hinduism. In Hinduism, they believe in horoscope. Kundali, Kundali. You know Kundali?
Yeah, I know.
It's called Kundali. Yes, you know, sister. When Kundali, you tell your date of birth, then they say that this sun was there, and this shagun, and this grahan came. This is a science. But this science is not established science. It's a hypothesis. It says that if you are born on this date, then this grahan comes and this planet goes there and this. It is a science, but it's not an established science. It's not hard science like what we read in our college, biology, physiology, embryology. It is what they believe. It's an assumption. And then they talk about future. Everything what they mention in the Kundalini does not come out to be true. We in Islam are against fortune telling. Quran says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90, Ya alladhina amanu, innama al-khamru wal-maisuru. Oh, you believe, most certainly intoxicant and gambling, wal anzabu wal aslamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rishtum min amali shaitan. These are Satan's handiwork. First tanibu lalukum tuflihun. Abstain from this handiwork that you may prosper. Quran says, this fortune telling, divination of arrows, they are Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it that you may prosper. So in Islam, we do not believe in this. You know, many a time, you go in a machine, you put your date of birth, then it comes out there. Something good is going to happen to you in the next 1 week. Even if 100 bad things happen, one good thing will surely happen. The next person goes, it comes horoscope, something bad is going to happen in the next 1 month. So these are statements that are made which are so ambiguous. And all this, you know, a parrot goes and picks up a chit, and you come to know your kundali or what your future. So in Islam, we don't believe a parrot can pick up and tell you what is your future, or by reading the palm or looking at the stars. Islam is against this. And many a time, you get fooled into believing that it is true. And there was a research done that once a psychologist, he was teaching a class of 100 students. And after 1 week, he said, now I have understood your background, everything. I will write about each individual person, about his past and everything. But don't open the chit until I tell you. So he wrote to all 100 students details about the past. Then he said, okay, now open the chits and give me gradation. How much am I accurate? Believe me. More than 95% of the students said the professor was more than 90% correct. The secret was, the professor wrote the same thing for everyone. These are such ambiguous statements. What we have to realize, sister, Islam is against fortune telling, against knowing about the future. That's the reason there's no kundli required. If the kundli was there, yet we find that so many marriages are being broken in Hinduism. Why? What we believe, that we have to choose our life partner. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's mentioned in Sahih Hadith, that whenever you choose your life partner, you look for 4 things. Beauty, wealth, nobility, and virtue. The best is virtue. The best to choose from a life partner is a virtuous life partner, not kundali. Whether born in October, September doesn't make a difference. The virtue should match. That is the reason a woman in Islam, sister, is called as a muhsana. Muhsana in Arabic means a fortress against the devil. In other religions, including Hinduism, the woman is referred as an instrument of a devil. In Quran, the woman is referred as a muhsana. In Arabic, it means a fortress against the devil. So if you marry a virtuous woman, inshallah, she will prevent the husband from going in the wrong track. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Thank you. Yes, sir. I just want to take Shahada.
MashaAllah. The sister who asked the question earlier, and I believe you're a Hindu sister.
Yeah, I'm Hindu.
Yes, the sister who had the earlier question, mashallah, Allah gave her hidayat and she wants to accept Islam. I want to ask you, sister, do you believe there is one God?
Yeah, I believe in
God. Do you believe that Almighty God has got no images?
Yes, sir, I believe.
Yes, and you believe that there's no one to worship besides Allah?
Yeah, I believe Allah is the greatest.
Do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the last and final messenger of this God?
Yes, I believe.
Inshallah, I'll say in Arabic and you repeat it, sister. Ashadu. I'll say in Arabic and repeat it, sister, slowly.
Okay.
Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
Wa ashadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Abduhu.
Abdu.
Wa rasuluhu.
Wa.
Wa rasu.
Wa rasuluhu.
Luhu. MashaAllah, sister. Sister, I'll just say the translation. I'll just mention the translation, sister. You just repeated the translation, which will be much more easier. I bear witness. I bear witness.
I bear witness.
That.
That.
There is no God.
That there is no God.
But Allah.
But Allah.
And Prophet Muhammad.
And Prophet Muhammad.
Is.
Is.
The messenger.
The messenger.
And servant of Almighty God.
And.
Servant of Almighty God.
Servant of Almighty God.
MashaAllah, sister. You are a Muslim. May Allah smile to reward you. And may Allah grant you Jannah. And sister, as I mentioned earlier, if you have any question, any queries, please don't feel shy. You can contact the local organizations here. If you have any questions, you can even send an email to our organization, islam@irf.net. We have a ladies wing which takes care of any questions, any queries, any problems you have. And sister, see to it that as you keep on learning whatever about Islam, slowly and steadily. Main thing is iman, believing. The practice keeps on coming slowly and steadily. Whatever you learn, you can ask questions, you can keep on following, and slowly and slowly, inshallah, inshallah, you can keep on following all the tenets of Islam. Thank you very much, sister.
Sir, is there any organization which can teach me how to pray, how to do all the things?
I'm sure there is an organization, Darul Bir. The organization I know in Dubai, Darul Bir, I'm sure there are lady organizations, and I think their sister Yasmin, who is the wife of my friend Brother Najmuddin. Surely Sister Yasmin would be somewhere in the ladies' wing. They have a ladies' organization. You can contact the volunteer, and inshallah, they'll help you out in teaching you how to pray, how to offer salah, and the other aspects of Islam. Thank you, sister.